Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Connor. I'm here with my father.
Kevin! I got even faster on that one.
Yeah. Today, we are doing another album reaction. This is Frank Ocean, Channel Orange. We have done Frank Ocean before. Mm-hmm. I threw you into Blonde maybe a little too early in your musical journey here. Because it kind of freaked you the fuck out, but you've grown to like it, right?
I've grown to like it. Yeah, it's not an album I go back to all the time. Mm. You know, I go to certain songs and
White Ferrari and
yeah, but I don't. We've been listening to so much stuff. I haven't, you know.
But your opinion changed after the first listen. Remember?
Completely about music in general.
Like not just Frank, but music in general.
Yeah, no, for sure. Just in music in general, because he was doing stuff that I hadn't heard before, and I was waiting for certain things and stuff. They didn't come in, but it really opened my mind to just explore mm-hmm. musically.
Okay, we will go into track number one, Start, and I'll let it play into track number two, Thinking About You.
A tornado flew around my room before you came. Excuse the mess it made. It usually doesn't rain. And thinking about you, oh no, no, no. I've been thinking about you, you, no, no, no. I've been thinking about you. But do you not think so far ahead? Cause I've been thinking about forever. When Idaho, since you think I don't. You, I just thought you were cute, that's why I kiss you. Got a fighter jet, I don't get to fly it, though I'm lying down thinking about you. Do you not think so far ahead?
This voice, man.
It's really, wow.
I've been thinking about forever. A new field.
I forgot how much I liked this voice. That was pretty damn cool. I got to say something right off the bat is that what I love about it is that everything musically seems like it has a wet towel over it. And that really, really works for me because...
Very soft.
Very soft. And it's like somebody took a snare and put a towel on it.
Mm-hmm.
You get that deadened thing.
Yeah.
And that's what every element in there worked.
The synths just the snare. It was the whole
song. The whole song. Everything was muted. So it was really, really soft to listen to, man.
Yeah.
His voice is, I forgot how great it is, man.
Yeah, we haven't really, you've heard snippets of Frank since we did Blonde, like through Kanye and other
but
Tyler and stuff.
In its entirety like that.
Yeah, no, so this is, yeah, I forgot. It's been a little while since you've heard
it. Yeah, when he hits the higher notes, it's really cool. But when he comes back down, especially on the second verse there, he has that undertone about him, man.
Mm.
Really cool. I have to say, this is right off the bat for me, like just like you said earlier.
Easier listening?
It's just, yeah, I just felt it. I just really felt this one.
Yeah, it's not like Blonde where it's, whoa, what is going on? Like,
where is
this going?
Like, I could probably listen to Blonde now and be like, if we did it all over again and it's gone through everything we've gone through, I'd be like, okay, I got it right. But this is more, it's got familiarity to it right away.
Yeah, for sure.
Right off the bat. That felt good.
So we'll go into track 3, Fertilizer, and then we'll let that play into track 4, Sierra Leone. Nice little interlude.
Like it's fertilizer. I'll take your shit, but it's so happy.
Yeah.
We're spending too much time alone.
Very muted again,
spending
eh?
Spending too much time alone. And I just ran out of Trojans. Horses gallop to a throne. Sierra.
I can't tell you how much I love the muted
element,
but his vocals are crystal clear.
Mm-hmm.
It's really cool.
just reaching for your nipple, cause it's time for her to breathe.
This is fucking really smoking, man. It's not. Oh, that was the bass there at the end there.
Yeah. Sorry, what were you saying?
It's smoking hot. Musically, it's so smoking hot. Like, you know what I'm getting at? You've heard it. You obviously heard this album. It's so ear appealing.
Yeah, it's easily accessible for anybody. Like, you can just listen, you can play it for almost anybody. Yeah, exactly. And they'll enjoy it. You know? Whereas Blonde has the experimental elements and stuff, and the pitch shifting and the weird chord progressions. Whereas this is like, you can put it on and just chill, and it's done perfectly. Track number 5 is titled Sweet Life.
Of Zach and Cody.
The best song wasn't the single, but you weren't either. Living in Ladera Heights, the Black Beverly Hills. Not sugar free, my TV ain't HD, that's too real.
He really paints a picture, right?
Mango peach.
I'm there right now.
Sweet life, sweet life, sweet life. Sweet life, sweet life.
I got back shirt with that, my man. You didn't tell me that was coming,
no.
You got the beach. Don't know why I see the world. And my sweet life.
Oh, that drop, eh? Look at
sweet life. Yeah.
Here it goes. I can feel it. Is it coming? Very Thundercat bass, eh?
100%, yeah.
Really. It's all over there, but it's leaving space, which is cool. It's just not...
It's not filling too much.
Yeah, just keeping... Fuck, he's got a Stevie Wonder tone in there.
100%.
That one... That was intense. That for me was the song.
Yeah.
That was it.
That's one of my favorites off the record.
Oh my God. And do you know what? You sitting there knowing that the chorus is going to come up, and I'm like listening to the whole thing going, okay.
I knew it was going to like shock you when it came in. Because it does build up, but like the chorus.
Well, you said, the drums are slowly coming in, and I thought it would just be.
And they slowly, progressively, but no, it just all
it was like,
at
boom,
once.
Boom, man. That this is my favorite song, like
so far.
Oh, hands down, man.
Yeah, no, I love that track.
His voice is here. When he does pitch shifting and that's all cool and like it's great artistically and all that kind of stuff. But when he just sings that chorus there, just his voice, fucking guy can sing.
Oh yeah, no, 100%.
That high Stevie Wonder feel, man.
And I absolutely love, like you said early on in the track, just painting the picture vividly.
The opening lyrics, the whole. You had a landscaper and a house since you were born. The sunshine always kept you warm. I could feel it. Mm-hmm. I pictured the whole, every time a lyric was coming out and I'm reading it, I'm picturing this whole thing. With the place and everything.
Yeah, it opens your imagination like while you're listening. It's just these pictures are coming up in your head.
I feel like this is one of these ones that we could have easily done on the water.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
Like it's that, I feel warm right now.
Well, I wanted to do this outside, but it's just the weather is so... This
unpredictable.
Month is so unpredictable with the wind and the rain and everything.
Yeah, this feels like an outdoor so far. It just feels like outdoor and chill. You're just like,
yeah.
Like, I'm enjoying this album. This is, I'm really digging this album.
Okay, we'll keep going. We'll go to track 6, Not Just Money, and we'll let that play into Super Rich Kids, which is featuring Earl Sweatshirt. You've probably heard that name a lot.
I've heard Earl Sweatshirt name a lot, and I've also avoided one recording where I recorded it and he was on a talk he was singing on the talk show, and everybody was blown away, and I think it was Fallon, because I read in comments, oh my God, Sweatshirt was on Fallon.
I didn't see that.
But yeah.
Anyway, this will be your first taste of Earl. This is young Earl. He was that's not his rap name, but he was he's pretty young at this stage his career.
I'm gonna make myself hot link when I get home. Meant nothing to you. Save my $7.
Too many bottles of this wine we can't pronounce. Too many bowls of that green, no Lucky Charms. Start my day up on the roof. There's nothing like this type of view. Point the clicker at the two. Good times, yeah.
Those freeze phrases were beautiful.
This shower head feels so amazing. Come around too
it's
much.
Going deep as like Tyler deep.
Yeah.
Parents ain't around
enough. Close your eyes to what you can't imagine. We are the Zanny Nashin', Caddy smashing, Braddy assy, Maddie snatched his daddy's jagging, use this shit for batting practice. Adam and Annie thrashing, purchasing crappy grams with half the hand of cash you handed. Don't believe us, treat us like we can't erupt. Yeah.
That was a great verse.
Yeah.
I love the pace he did.
Yeah, you like Earl?
Yeah. I like his pacing. It was really cool.
Fit the song perfectly.
Exactly. It didn't.
Do they so wings until it suits? I'm on that ledge. Talking about real love.
That was cool.
Yeah, you like that?
That was very. I thought of at the beginning, I thought it was the beginning of, I thought it was a sample of Benny and the Jets.
Oh, because the chords.
Bam, bam,
bam,
bam,
yeah.
Bam. And I'm like, oh my God, this is Benny. He took that, he sampled that from Benny and the Jets, but obviously it wasn't. You know what? His voice there again surprised me because I thought it was going to, that was Tyler there. I'm like,
because how deep his voice was.
Yes.
Went.
It's how he goes.
Yeah, Frank is, you know, you're used to him doing the really high.
Yeah, and then the real
oh, with the pitch shift.
The pitch shifting, yeah. But too many bottles of wine we can't pronounce. That's not it. But
no. And you liked Earl.
I really liked Earl, and I think Earl did it really justice. Like if he came in and did it any quicker or anything, but he stayed at that pace.
The same pace as Frank.
Yeah, but he also stayed at the pace, but he also had
the same
areas.
Tone.
No, but where he jumped in and he did the three. Like he went quicker.
Yeah, but he stayed slow. It's yes. Weird.
He went quick, but he stayed at the pace.
Track number 8, Pilot Jones.
You always smoking in the house. What if my mother comes over? Know what I was on? I had a Pilot Jones.
What you know about that?
She took me high.
This is so fucking peaceful.
Yeah. This album is one you want to listen to outside, like just going on a walk or something.
Yeah. It's. It's getting closer. That was cool.
Yeah.
It was not my favorite of the whole thing, but I think it was really, really cool. And you know what I wanted to say? Did Frank ever do anything with Gambino? Have they ever got together?
Have they?
It would be a vocal fucking... It would be crazy. No?
I don't know, actually. I know... That's Chance.
Because vocally, like, man, they're both... Like, I'm still blown away, man, with like Redbone and all that kind of stuff.
Mm.
Like, and his voice as well. Like he went to the straight R&B voice in the chorus of the track two ago, and he did his straight just non falsetto, not singing super high or doing anything, but he just sang his thing. But he really is versatile, and like him and Gambino have something with their.
Yeah, voice. I don't know if they've worked together actually, but I feel like I would know that if they have. So I'm assuming not.
Yeah.
But if anybody knows, please.
Yeah, that would be crazy. Or maybe it might be too much. Maybe one's going, yeah, And I was like, woo. You know what I mean? Yeah. And then it's all.
And, then you just, and you throw Kid Cudi in there. He goes, woo.
And they're all riffing off each other. Yeah. And like sometimes it's too much, right?
Track number 9 is titled Crack Rock.
How little you matter until you're all alone in the middle of Arkansas with a little rock left in that glass stick to hit them stones and broke your home. Crack rock, crack rock, crack rock, crack rock, crack rock, crack rock.
This is really sad, this song.
It is.
It makes me think of here, Vancouver.
You're shucking and jiving, stealing and robbing to get the fixing that you're itching for. An abandoned home.
This is a really good hook.
Sad. Sad. Yeah, hook, yeah. But.
And you broke your home. Crack rock. Crack rock, crack rock. How's the gutter doing? Crack rock.
That's fucking, wow, that's a powerful, powerful track.
Lyrically really powerful.
Really, really good. And the way the ride runs right through that whole song, and then that's a really, man, that's a hard-hitting song, dude.
Yeah,
I don't mean you, dude, but...
No, I agree.
And then the way he's saying crack rock and he's just saying it, and at the end when he sings it...
Yeah, for the most part, he's not singing it. It's just crack rock, crack rock.
Then at the very end when he holds those notes and it's really, really strong, man, it's accentuated, right?
Yeah, no.
Wow, that's the first one that I've heard, like a Frank of like
storytelling.
And... Storytelling of a really dark, dark subject.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
Right? It's usually, what I've been feeling is lots of love and love loss and new love and stuff, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But that's a pretty, I wonder if that touches home with somebody he's known or something, right?
Yeah. Okay, we'll keep going. Actually,
you wanted to get some tea. I think I want to get a drink too, so. Hey, how you doing? Oh my God. Look at this. It's Bob. Bob the Pop. How you doing, Bob?
Should I just make up lyrics?
Just falsetto. I'll throw you the lyrics and you just sing them in that falsetto while we're doing this.
Okay.
You want me to say, trees, all people are trees.
Okay.
Okay?
Track number 10, Pyramids.
Set the cheetahs on the loose. Bring her back to me. Run,
wow. Wow, this is grand.
We'll run to the future, shining like diamonds in a rocky world. I keep you bird voices fill up the house. Set the cheetahs on the loose. You feel like God inside the
globe. This was made 10 years ago? Wow. Fuck me.
It sounds
like something The Weeknd put out today, sonically.
From a black queen, Cleopatra, Cleopatra, Cleopatra.
Holy man.
This part sounds new.
Very, wow. Wow. I just love that fatness.
I knew you'd like this one.
She's working at the pyramid tonight. Working at the pyramid. Working at the pyramid tonight. Bills paid. Hit the strip and my bills paid. Keep a nigga bills paid. Working at the pyramid, yeah, yeah.
Instrumentally, it's just so grand on this track.
It's huge, man. It's 10 minutes. Like, everything in that 10 minutes is epic.
Mm-hmm. I just absolutely love the deep synth bass.
I'm just listening. It's so fat in the headphones.
Okay.
Okay. What I wanted to remind you of is that I can't even talk here. How, again, I've said this every time we've done this, but like on a track like that, it's 10 minutes long, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm getting there's two stories going on.
Yes, yeah. There is like a slight beat change. It's not like the night's beat change, but there is one in there, yeah.
First off, I'm going to go start sonically. It sounds like something that just literally dropped, and I know I know 10 years ago isn't really that far away in terms of that, but it just...
Well, if you think of the music that was being released 10 years ago, I mean, 2012, was it LMFAO, Party Rock Anthem and stuff?
Gangnam Style?
Yeah,
okay, yeah. then here you go, like right there, like right that. Was like,
no, there was great music in 2012 as well, don't get me wrong, but I'm just teasing. But
and then the two stories going on, I'm assuming that first part is back in Cleopatra, mm-hmm, right?
Yes.
And then second is now pyramids, I'm assuming, is the strip club she works at and that, right?
Yes.
Am I right? Because I'm
Bang on.
Okay, because that's what I was feeling, don't know if it's right. But to connect everything in 10 minutes with all that
instrumental
that's going on, and to make it sound fucking epic, and to finish off with something just so spatial and reverse guitars and all that kind of stuff, and to complete that, this is where I'm going from what I said, to don't forget, is that I can't finish fucking 25 seconds of music
of a song.
So every time I listen to an artist blown away that people complete projects, right? Because I'm just a non-finisher. That's something I got to do in my life. I got to finish one fucking track. That's good.
Yeah.
Right? It might be Trees, right?
Track number 11, Lost.
Oh, Double D, Big Full Breasts on My Baby.
Best lyric on the album.
Double D, Big Full Breasts on My Baby.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
I'm grooving already. Like,
Double D, big full breast on my baby. Now you're lost in the heat of it all. Girl, you know you're lost. Silk shirt and it's Versace.
See, that's how he gets my...
What?
Like how he very descriptive. So I pictured buttercream.
And Versace.
Right? Yeah.
No, I don't really wish. I don't wish the titties were sharp. Lost in a thrill of it all.
And I was going to say, I like the way he doesn't rhyme totally.
No. Yeah, just...
You don't have to rhyme, right?
Los Angeles, India, lost on a train, love.
Faith is the substance.
That's Lost.
That is a catchy little track.
It's very catchy. It's very short, very catchy. But it doesn't overstay its welcome, and it's just
very
something
catchy.
You want to just jam out to.
Yeah, I just want to dive into the lyrics more. I think that there's more to it than I'm getting.
Yeah.
I gotta really decipher these. Okay, that makes sense. I just dove into it now. Or the protagonist in the song is a drug supplier who uses his girlfriend as a drug mule, his lover. That's what I figured, right?
Mm-hmm.
I could feel that, right?
Yeah, he does a lot of storytelling on this record, which is...
very descriptive.
Yeah. And it's, I like that side of Frank Ocean. I don't get me wrong. I love hearing about Frank's personal life, but, when he's going into these stories and crafting them into these beautiful short pieces of,
yeah,
of music. It's fantastic.
And that's that other creative side that I just, I don't get, because I always write from my perspective, right? And I, to go in and write from somebody else's perspective and tell a story is very difficult to do. You can't, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It is. It's hard.
It's definitely challenging, but I think there's also upside to it, because then you have unlimited creativity.
That's for sure.
Whereas, like, yeah, if you're writing just from your perspective, you kind of have to stay true to yourself. Whereas if you've created this character, you can kind of, yeah, expand more into stuff
for sure. I've never thought of creating a character. It would be cool to actually create a character and then funnel my stuff into that character, because then that's a good way, you know, that then they don't really think it's me.
Well, yeah, there's this album behind you. Can you see on camera? Yeah. Arctic Monkeys, Tranquility, yeah, Base Hotel. It's my favorite Arctic Monkeys project, and it is a almost like a science fiction like album.
Yeah.
It's based off a hotel and casino that's on the moon.
Oh,
and
wow.
He's like a a singer-songwriter in this, yeah, hotel on the moon. It's really cool.
Oh my god. You know, you just got me in there, because like no, because you know how much I'm a Blade Runner freak, right?
Yeah.
And I love when they, at the scene when they go into the old casino,
mm-hmm,
right? At the and he's hiding in there and stuff like, yeah, that. And then the holograms of Frank and Sinatra and that.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I just thought of right then.
Yeah. Track 12, White. Sometimes John Mayer gets a bad rap, but I think he's a fantastic guitar player.
So do I. I'll tell you. Can we talk through this a little bit?
Yeah, it's almost over.
Okay. Our accountant at work came by and gave me I'm going to say a CD, a DVD, okay?
Mm-hmm.
About this guy. I'm dating myself here. About this guy who's a guitar player, plays an acoustic, but he's only playing colleges right now.
Mm-hmm.
He goes around and tours colleges. And anyway, she had some footage that he gave me. Turns out it was John Mayer.
Really?
Yeah, it was cool. He was playing, her name's Winifred. Shout out to Winifred. I know you're not watching, but she gave me, she goes, you got to watch this. My friend got footage from wherever, and it was from, and it got onto DVD, and she gave it to me. And it was him doing like the really early stuff when he only played acoustic, right?
Yeah, there's a video actually. Have you ever seen I think the song is called No Such Thing. Do you know that,
yes,
song?
Yes, yeah.
And he's, yeah, I think it looks like it's in like an auditorium or something.
Yeah,
in
yeah,
the video. That, yeah,
so
and
this,
he's
there was
acoustic.
Yeah, so there was some footage that somebody had shot of this. And then when I started hearing him, and then he just went from 0 to 60, like he was playing acoustic and that, and then he went on to a Strat, and
Now
he's just, yeah, he's regarded. He's playing with the Grateful Dead, touring with the Grateful Dead.
Yeah, yeah,
doing that. But he's playing a PRS, Paul Reed Smith, with a. It looks like a Fender. It looks like a Strat, but it's a PRS. It's just a copy.
Track 13 is titled Monks.
Stage diver, skydiver, spray the crowd with cold water. Now it's my spits and wet sits to me. Ooh. Wave them high, girl, to the sky. But she's beautiful. In the sky.
Oh, yeah.
Monks in the mosh pit. Stage diving, Dalai Lama. I pay Mudra.
That was a hot fill, man. Yeah.
But please keep up the lever. We've got no choices left. Run.
The only thing I can think of right now on the so drums is that Japanese.
Oh, that. Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Japanese caricature.
Father's army trailing us. We escaped him. Guide and protect us to the end.
Oh, man. Holy, who's playing drums on that motherfucker?
I don't know, actually.
Holy shit. We got to find out that.
Yeah.
I want to find out who's playing that. Those were insane.
Yeah, no, that was awesome. I knew you were going to love that track right off the bat.
Hear that last one? That fill is, yeah, like...
A... Yeah, no, that's a fantastic track. Another short one, but it's just yeah.
That had literally all of the elements that I love.
Yeah.
Either wee, that synth came in there. Wee.
The synth, the drums, the bass, and then Frank.
Yeah, and then Frank, and then runs were absolutely fucking beautiful harmonies.
Yeah.
Right in the middle of there. Run. The, really cool track, man.
Track number 14, Bad Religion.
Taxi driver, be my shrink for the hour. Leave the meter running. Allahu Akbar, I told him don't curse me. But boy, you need prayer. I guess it couldn't hurt me. To me, it's nothing but a one-man cult. To me, it's nothing but a one-man cult. In cyanide, my styrofoam cup could have me feeling the way I do.
I gotta say, first thing first, his where to be able to go from a falsetto. I guess it couldn't hurt me if it brings me to my knees. That mm-hmm. line there, that it's line, a yeah. battle of religion. It's like he's going from that not falsetto. I don't know if he's probably hitting the. He's not having to do the throat singing, right?
No.
And then he goes opens. It's just like it's like fucking 0 to 60. It's like. Boom.
Yeah.
Right? Like yeah. to do that must be, again, you just go, my bow, my nipples would pop right out.
Yeah, no, and I love the subject matter on this, like how he just paints this picture of him talking with this taxi driver and
you know, I know.
Talking through his problems. And
again, it's one of those ones where it's, he just, like, he's sitting there in the back of a cab, right?
Yeah.
Balance on my head like three steak knives. Parts of me, with Frank's music, I realize is that, especially from Blonde, and then only on actually I just started to feel it on this track here right now. It's like when I would go to an art show or something, which I have actually gone to some art shows and stuff.
Yeah, me too.
And I've watched some. Other people have got what the art piece is, and I still I feel like the stupid one sitting there and going, oh yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then after I'll be asking, and then it's like, oh no, that represents, you know what I mean?
This and that.
Yeah, the poverty of whatever, chickens or whatever.
Yeah.
And I'll be like, oh, that, okay, now it makes sense or whatever. Something Frank's stuff is like that in terms of like, it's sort of like Radiohead as well. Some artists just spill it right out or whatever. But this one here, I was just trying to get it the whole, then I'm starting to understand it that he's talking about, you know, someone who's never going to love him back, mm-hmm, right?
Yeah.
And then he's talking in the cab and all that kind of stuff. But before this, where he says, and you say Allahu Akbar, and I told him, don't curse me, Bobo, you need a prayer. But then I got it in the second verse, right?
Mm-hmm. Track 15, Pink Matter featuring André 3000.
Ooh.
You like André.
I like André.
And the peaches and the mangoes that you could sell for me. Sensei replied, what is your woman? Is she just a container for the child?
Listen to the background in this, man.
Mm-hmm.
What if the sky and the stars are for show, and the aliens are watching live?
Ooh, that's tripping me out.
The purple matter giving me pleasure.
I got, man, I'm fucking floored. Of how this is mixed.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's tripping me out, to be honest.
Since you've been gone, I've been having withdrawals. You were such a habit to call. I ain't myself at all, had to tell myself no. She better with some fella with a regular job. I didn't want to get her involved. By dinner, Mr. Benjamin was sitting in awe. If models are made for modeling, thick girls are made for cuddling. Switch worlds and we can huddle in. Who needs another friend? I need to hold your hand. You need no other man. We flee to other lands. With no mask on and a rest to revolve.
Wow, I have to tell you, and in all honesty, I actually tripped out there for a second.
Why is that?
I had my eyes closed at the beginning of the track, and then the guitar was panned over here so far to my right, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I had to check my thing. So far to the right, and then there was that spatial thing going on, and then I had my eyes closed, and I'm going to sound like I'm fucking took some kind of drugs or something here, but Frank's voice with my eyes closed was floating right in front of me going like
you
this.
You could almost like visualize it.
He was right in front of me like this, man. However they did that and that chanting thing that was going on.
Yeah, in the back, it was kind of like a distorted, far away chant.
Yes, and it was far enough away that it brought him really close to my face in the headphones. And then that guitar put me off too because he was way back here. And then the other thing was way back here, right? And then Frank was right here in the that was trippy.
And what about André?
André was very cool. Yeah. I got to say, André was very cool.
Another good rap feature in the sense, like, you know how Earl fit the song?
Yeah.
I'd say André fit it perfectly. Like, he didn't go overboard. He didn't do anything too crazy. It's just was perfect. His perfect delivery and flow. And
yeah, differently. I have to dive into the lyrics on this one because this is one of these ones where I feel like I'm like fucking like the guy in the art place who doesn't get it. Everybody gets it, right?
Yeah, yeah. Track number 16 is titled Forrest Gump. You've seen Forrest Gump, right?
I've seen it 30 times.
Or have you seen the, I know you've seen the other version.
Forrest Pump?
Forrest Pump.
Or
yeah.
Foreskin Pump.
Foreskin Pump, that's it, yeah.
Life is like a box of condoms. If you don't wear one, you never know what you're going to get.
That's true. That's the rule I live by. Okay.
Pump, Forrest, pump. Pump, Forrest, pump.
Track number 16, Forrest Pump. I was about to say it.
Foreskin Pump.
Track number 16, Forrest Gump.
My fingertips and my lips, they burn from the cigarettes. Forrest Gump, you run my mind, boy. I know you're Forrest. I know you wouldn't hurt a beetle. I saw your game, Forrest. I was screaming, run 44. But you kept running past the end zone. Oh, no, no, it's you. Oh, you. It's for you, Forrest. Forrest Gump.
I like whistling in songs. I haven't heard that in a long time. That's a great track. Yeah, I got to, again, lyrically, I got to dive into that because there is reference, like it's directly, it is Forrest Gump.
Yeah.
That's cool that somebody wrote with the name Forrest Gump.
Yeah, no, I know you seemed a little surprised when you were looking through the track list and you saw Forrest Gump.
Well, I thought that maybe, you know, he's used the title and then the song would be something about the things that happened in Forrest Gump, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, like the way, love loss and all that kind of stuff. So I thought it was going to use
shrimp
that.
Shrimp and stuff.
Shrimp and shrimp Creole.
But yeah, no, we got one more song left. It's titled End.
Looks like all we've got is each other. The truth is absolute.
Yeah, all the interlude things, skits, and the start and the end has like a lo-fi-ish.
Yeah, it's like
feel to it.
Right from the get-go to the end.
Mm-hmm. It really splits up the album, you know, with these.
But I love what it does sonically because like you get into this headspace, and then you sort of get used to this for a bit, and then you're brought in for the full mix.
Yeah, for the real song afterwards.
Yeah, it's like it's. I feel like I'm spying on somebody. Hey? It's really creepy. I put a microphone in their house. Okay. That was it?
Yeah, that's the album.
Oh, that's a great. That one threw me off at the end.
The end? Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it kind of it's like ties into the whole theme with the, you know, there's like the tuning of the radio stations at
the
one
beginning,
point and,
yeah.
and stuff like that. So it's kind of, you know, it all ties together. It's.
Well, oh, yeah. You know what? He's the car guy.
Forgot. No, that's Tyler.
No, he's also car.
He's been, yeah, big into cars,
he's too. He's big into cars, too, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lamborghinis and stuff like that.
Yeah. But I think one of Tyler's albums ends with him getting in a car or something.
Oh, does it?
Okay, or yeah. Getting out of a car. I don't know. Something like that. Anyway, the album. What do you think?
I think it's more than I expected. Because I thought that maybe it would be sort of the same as
Closer to Blonde,
but this is for my preference. I dig it, everything about it. It's yeah. really good, synth wise, drum wise. I got to find out who the drummer is on that track.
On Monks, yeah.
Yeah, that was really, really good. Having Mayer on there, Mayer was not doing his conventional, you know, stuff, but he had some reverse going on the back end of that track.
Pearl.
Vocals were great. It was really, really easy. Was it Crack, the song?
Crack Rock,
I thought was very strong and very strong track, a very deep track, right?
The two rap features you enjoyed, Earl, André.
I liked Earl. I thought Earl did a really good job in sticking in the confines of what the subject matter and tone, yeah. And same with André. I've always liked André, so I can't wait to do André because that's...
Yeah, yeah. If you guys made it all the way to the end of the video, I just want to say thank you. We appreciate it. We love you lots. Do you have any closing thoughts? Closing words.
Words of wisdom. Words of wisdom. You know what? I'll give you some words of wisdom. Okay?
Okay.
Always take care of yourself.
Yeah.
How's that?
Just in general?
In general, yeah. Always take care of yourself. Eat right. Do things. Exercise. And think. Try to think positive.
Don't overwork yourself.
That is the key. Don't overwork yourself. Make sure you take time to enjoy your family and your friends and just have relaxation
and time. Take time to yourself too, you know, take a day where you just relax.
Yeah. Have a bath.
Yeah.
Did you have a bath last night?
I'm going to have one today.
I thought you had one.
I was going to, but I got tired and I didn't want to fall asleep in the bath. So I bought a new bath bomb, so I want to try it out.
Oh, right on.
Yeah. But, just take care of yourself.
Yeah.
Do some self care and, yeah, enjoy the summer that is about to
start. Well, maybe other people have summer started, really.
We don't in Vancouver, not yet, at least. But
one, like literally in the morning, we're wearing shorts and then hoodies and then pants and then
raincoats.
Raincoats
and then
we're
starting a fire and then we're just to stay warm.
Yeah, and then the air conditioner's out for 45 minutes.
Yeah, it's weird time
yeah,
here.
Yeah, no, strange.
But take care, guys. And we'll see you very soon with some more album reactions. So stay tuned.
All the best. Take care.
Peace.